Hello everybody and welcome to HD Piano. My name is Dan, and in this lesson I'll show you how to play Take Me Home Country Roads by John Denver. We're going to look at the intro and verses in this first of five videos. They sound like this. 3, 4. On to the chorus. The rest of this lesson will be found at hdpiano.com if you're not already there. Question for you guys before I dive in. Are you country folk or are you city folk? Personally, I kind of grew up in between, just outside of the city, but lots of farms around me. Curious about your perspective. Comment below. This is middle C right here. We're in the key of A major. And my metronome is at 82 beats per minute, which is where John Denver famously recorded it. All right, let's first talk about this intro, and then I'll break down the melody, and then we'll talk about what the left hand is doing with its accompaniment. So here's the quick, short intro. The left hand's just playing A and E, and then E, E, A, E, A, E, F sharp, A. Right hand is playing alternatingly, rhythmically, on E and C sharp. And it has that little filler there. That's C natural, C sharp, E. If you can hold that E, that'll sound really cool. Otherwise, if you just play, that's cool too. So here's the intro super slow. 3 and 4. Right, verse. Let's talk about the melody. Almost heaven, West Virginia. Right? It's going to match the vocal. This is a melody arrangement. It's rare that we do this, but there's no piano in the recording, so we thought it fitting to actually arrange a vocal featured piano part. So we have E, E, F sharp, E, and then F sharp, E, F sharp, A, and then B, B, C sharp, B, F sharp, F sharp, F sharp, E, A, A. Again, let's recap that first phrase. Okay. Then the female voice comes in and we have harmony. This is cool. So it's C sharp and E, up to D and F sharp, back down to C sharp and E. Keep that C sharp in the bottom. The right hand is going to play F sharp, A, A. Pop it all up to E and C sharp, and the bottom goes up to F sharp. So here's those two measures again. Very good. Moving on. We have G sharp and B, up to A and C sharp, back down to G sharp and B. So. Here we have F sharp alone, and then add the A on top, move the bottom down to E, then that A goes to neighboring B, back down to A. And then into our chorus, which we'll be learning in the second video. Let's play through the verse melody, which is the part the voice sings. Let's play through it at a slow tempo. 3 and 4 and 1. Awesome. I'm going to turn my metronome on. We'll do that same thing at recorded speed, 82 beats per minute. Two, ready, and... Three and four. Work that out on your own, and we're going to be adding the left hand next, which I'm afraid it doesn't make anything easier, but it really rounds out the sound. What the left hand is doing, if the right hand is the voice, the left hand is the guitar, right? And maybe bass. We're hearing this sort of dun, 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 this sort of strumming feel. And so let's actually walk through the chords. They're all going to be subject to the same sort of format, which is this spread tenth. You'll never need to play these notes together. I'm fortunate enough to be able to, but you'll be playing them separately, bottom and top two. So we start with this A chord, A, E, C sharp, and then this F sharp minor chord, F sharp, C sharp, A. The next split triad is E in the bottom, and then B, G sharp, the top of the voice. And then a D chord, D in the bottom, A, F sharp in the top. And then we're back home to A. That's our verse chord progression. So get familiar with it. It's A, it's F sharp minor, then E, then D, and back home to A. You can write that down if need be, whatever it takes to commit the chord progression to memory, because now we're going to subject it to this format. It's one, two. I think we'll ever be playing it quite that fast, but that's the idea. It's bottom and then the top two notes. And we're playing it with this rhythm. Short, long, short, short, long, short, short, long, short, short, long. And we have a little bass fill. Boom, 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 boom. That's A, E, E, F sharp, and then doing it again. Da, da, West Virginia. Oh, this would be the second half of the verse. Da, da. And then the second half of the verse, we do have a new left hand. A little bit of a moving bass line. D, D, C sharp, B, A, E, E, F sharp. All right. I like to put all this together, left and right hand. It will be a challenge. So I'm actually going to offer up a simplified version. You could do octaves, or fifths might sound more appropriate. It's less filling, right? It doesn't quite have the same harmonic density that we need, I think, but it works. And you can still tell that it's Take Me Home. So that's an option for those of you guys that are struggling, particularly with the left hand, all right? So I'm gonna play, now that we've learned the left and right separately, I'm just gonna play this verse really, really slowly, okay, up to the chorus. One, two, and ready, and hands together. Good, let's try a medium speed. One E and two E and ready and play. Thank you. the metronome on, 82 beats per minute. Two, ready, and verse. Fantastic work if you're still with me, everybody. This is Take Me Home Country Roads by famous John Denver. We're going to learn the rest at hdpiano.com, but if you are on YouTube, comment below. Are you city folk or are you country folk? Send your song ideas to requests.hdpiano.com, then go hunt us down on social media and say hey. Again, I'm Dan. I'll see you over at the home of the hybrid piano lesson, hdpiano.com.